Thank you, Victor. As mentioned already before, the number of options we have to control trips is more and more limited due to regulatory challenges, but also due to challenges from the market. And therefore, in our opinion, every application has to be optimal. And because of that, Syngenta has done a lot of work in research to see how we can optimize the effect of insecticides against trips. One of the things is, of course, application technology, where we already talked about in the previous webinar. And I would like now to focus a bit more on the use of adjuvants and the use of liquid sugars in particular. The use of liquid sugars is not new, especially here in Europe. It's quite commonly used. And it's already discovered by the Wageningen University at around the year 2000. There they found that with very low amounts of abamectin, so the Dynamec, in combination with liquid sugar, the effect against trips was improving. They only also found that it only works with the liquid sugars, that are sugars that are normally used for bumblebee hives in mainly tomato production or in fruit production. They couldn't make it work with other types of sugar, for example, the solid sugars that we use for coffee or tea. They also found that it mainly works with products that act on the nerve system. And within Syngenta, we also did some trials with Match, for example, which is an IGR. And indeed, there we didn't see any added value of sugars on TRIPS control. After Wageningen University found this effect, a lot of mode of actions are attributed to this liquid sugar. And it's still not completely clear how it works and why it is improving some of the active ingredients. Some of the researchers think that they have a more attract and kill effect, like we know, for example, with ants. If you combine their sugar with chemical products, we know that the ants are attracted by the sugar. It stimulates feeding and increases nutritional intake. So by stimulating the feeding, they think that there are more active ingredient into the insect. Some think that it's increasing the contact with the insect by just sticking to the insect, or that it increases the intake and the consumption by cleaning. Most of the insects try to wash off dust and other things from their bodies. And also some people think that it's the uptake of active ingredient increases through the cuticula of the top cell layers into the plant. Again, so far that the exact mode of action is still not found, and most probably it's in a combination of all factors. Within Syngenta, we've done quite some research over the last year, because we are launching in Europe and hopefully also next year in Africa products based on cyanthineniprole. And in Europe, we already launched 2 years ago, and this product will be launched in Kenya next year with a strong focus on TRIPS control. So therefore, we did some research, and one of the things we checked is is there a difference in spreading and drying time if you use liquid sugars in combination with the active ingredient. And here we saw under an electron microscope that there was no difference in drying time or in spreading. But what we saw here is that the crystals from the active ingredient or from the product are covered by a film as soon as they are combined with a sugar. So after drying, there was a difference. However, also with the microscopy, it showed that there is no difference in the form of the crystals. So it's only the way that they are covered with a kind of film. And there's also no difference in the dissolvability of the crystals. They dissolve in the same way. So in these trials, we didn't see any evidence of uptake enhancement or in differences in degradation. Some other studies are also done. One was to to demonstrate the effect of attractiveness. And therefore we did a selection test where trips could choose between an area that was treated with sugar and untreated, but we didn't see any increase of consumption or attractiveness by the sugar. And we also didn't see any effect on behavior, though we saw in all those trials that the liquid sugar improved the effect of the scientific pull against trips. And one of the things we saw, this active ingredient is quite fast in acting. Normally insects stop within minutes. You have to think about 30, 40 minutes after the intake, they stop feeding. But in the combination with the sugar, we saw that it was even faster than without the sugar. The exact effect behind this still has to be investigated. And what we also still need to investigate if there's indeed an effect of the stickiness of the sugar, so that the active ingredient better sticks to the insect, if there's a result in brushing or cleaning of the insect, and if there's an influence on the cuticula. So again, we know that it works, but the exact mode of action is still not known. To show the effect of the sugar, we have done several trials. And in all those trials, we did two applications. And we checked the effect 3 weeks until 3 weeks after the application. And here in this trial, you see the effect of Actara in combination with the sugar liquid sugar. And with Actara, we always have an effect of around 80 to 90% control in the combination. And in the second bars, you see the effect of the cyanotinidoprol solo. And it's quite normal for us to see that the effect is around 40%. Then we did the sugar additives solo, and there you see no effect at all. But in the combination with cyanotinidoprol, the active ingredient, and the sugar, we see that again, we can increase the efficacy up to 80 to 90%. So the liquid sugars improve the effect on mainspring of the cyanotinidoprol on trips, but the sugar itself has no effect. We compare this with other types of adjuvants, and that's what you see here in this trial. On the left-hand side, again, the Actara with the liquid sugar, again, around 90% control. The cyanotinidoprol in combination, again, with the 90% control. And then we tested two different types of adjuvants. And from both adjuvants, you see that they don't have that similar effect. The first adjuvant is a more organosilicone type of product, which is more a spreader type of product. And the second adjuvant is a more oil-based product. So far with TRIPS, we only see the effect with sugar and not with other adjuvants. For other pests, of course, this is completely different. There, some adjuvants can have an additional effect compared to others. From practice, we know that most growers use about 0.25%. For us, was the question, is that the optimal dose or is there a dose response? Therefore, we did a trial to look at the dose rates. And what you here see on the right-hand side of this graph is the cyanotinidoprol in combination with 0.25% of liquid sugar, half a dose rate and a quarter of a dose rate. And it's very clear here that with the very the lowest dose rate, the effect is less combined compared to the other ones. So the minimum dose rate of the sugar is 0.1 to 5%, and we recommend a dose rate between 0.1 to 5 and 0.25 to have consistent results during the applications. We also tested several different brands. You can see here the four bars on the right hand side, sugar 1, 2, 3, and 4, are different brands of liquid sugars. And there you see there is no difference between the different sugar brands. As long as it's the liquid sugar that's used for bumblebee feeding, the effect will always be the same. So, in summary, the liquid sugars can improve the effect of insecticides, but it only works with nerve-acting insecticides. And it also only works with the liquid sugars, not with the solid, not with solid sugars. The mode of action is still not clear, We are doing more research on that. And the recommended dose rate is minimum 0.1 to 5%. And we haven't seen any differences between the different brands. So with this, I hope that to give you a bit more insight on the use of adjuvants and sugar in particular on the improvement and optimization of TRIPS control in practice.